Yesterday, or day before yesterday, we finished on, I think yesterday, yeah. So we finished on acidic and basic oxides, okay, metal oxides and non-metal oxides. I told you that most of them are not metal oxides and non-metal oxides, but few of them are neutral and amphoteric in nature. And acids are prepared from acidic oxides, and alkalis are prepared from basic oxides, okay, from the metal oxides. Now you can see here in this table about metals and non-metals. Yeah, here in the first three, sulfur phosphorus, some of the non-metals are written, and then some of the metals are written, and there are different columns. Three columns are here, okay. And in this table, in the first column, it's written how it reacts, okay. How it reacts means how it burns, okay. Mostly it's how it burns. So these non-metals, they burn with different color flames. They produce different colors, okay. So like when we, if we have a Bunsen burner, okay, like this, a Bunsen burner, and we burn it, okay, there's a flame. So when we bring these metals or non-metals near it, okay, in a spatula, when we bring it near, when we bring these metals or non-metals near it, so they burn and they produce different flames. Okay, the flame shows different colors. So that's how, this is one way we can identify these metals and non-metals also. Okay, so this is known as flame test. So inshallah, in next grade, in grade 9 or in grade 10, you have to learn the flame test, that which colors they will produce. Okay, right now at this stage, you don't have to learn all of them, that what is the color. Like for example, for the sulfur, sulfur burns with bright blue flame. Okay, so you have to learn for the important ones. So learn for sulfur, or in the non-metals, learn for sulfur and carbon. Okay, sulfur burns with bright blue flame and carbon glows red. Okay, so the flame will glow red. So these colors, these colors are actually the indications also. So if we have, for example, if we have any powder and we want to test that whether it's a metal or a non-metal, and which metal or which non-metal is this, so we can do a, we can perform a flame test also before doing any other reaction. Okay, so from the flame test also, it indicates that this might be present in this, okay, in this powder. And then about the metals, metals again, the flame test is written. It burns with yellow flame. Magnesium burns with bright white flame. Calcium burns with red flame. So there are different different colors are written. So for in the metals, learn for the sodium, calcium, iron, and copper also. Magnesium is left. You can learn for magnesium also, because that is also important. Okay, but learn for few of them. Like if it comes to give the example of a flame test, that how it burns, how metal burns or how non-metal burns, so you should know the colors of them. Okay, for some of them, sodium with yellow flame, calcium with red flame, iron with yellow spark, and copper does not burn; it only turns black. Okay, because when we burn copper, it does not burn. Actually, it starts reacting with the atmospheric oxygen. Okay, and it forms copper oxide powder, which is black in color. So it does not burn, it just reacts with oxygen to form copper oxide. Okay, so it turns black. What is the original color of copper? Do you know?
Golden
brown.
Yeah, it's pink, pinkish brown.
Rose gold.
Yeah, okay, like it's dull gold. But it's more, it's pinkish brown in color, copper, the pure copper. Okay, and then in the next column, their product is written, means their reaction with oxygen. Okay, how it reacts with oxygen. Reaction with oxygen, they form their sulfur dioxide, phosphorus oxide, carbon dioxide, sodium oxide. Okay, their reaction with oxygen is written, and their product color is written. Okay, colors, it's not compulsory to learn these colors. Okay, because there are so many, so no need to learn these colors of their oxides. Okay, but you should know that which oxide they will form. Okay, and the formula of these oxides. And the formula of these oxides, you can make the formula from their valencies. Okay, and from the cross method, you can guess that what will be the formula of these compounds. of these oxides. Okay, so their oxides, their formulas are important, colors are not important. And for the next one, the next column, effect of adding water means either they dissolve in water or not dissolve, and their color in the litmus paper. So for the non-metal, it's really easy. All of them dissolves in water and they turn blue litmus paper red. Blue to red, okay? And for the non-metals, the first three non-metals, sodium, magnesium, and calcium, they dissolve in water and turn red litmus paper blue, obviously because they give alkalis, okay? And the last two, iron and copper, they are insoluble in water. Okay, so iron oxide, Fe2O3, it's insoluble. Okay, so we can prepare its hydroxide. Okay, we can prepare its hydroxide not directly dissolving in water, but we can prepare it indirectly from any other method. Okay, from any other reaction or any other method, we can prepare it. We have the alkali of iron also. Okay, iron hydroxide, but we will prepare it indirectly. It cannot be prepared by directly dissolving in water because it's insoluble. Are you getting it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Similarly, for copper oxide also, we have copper hydroxide, we have copper alkali, okay? But we cannot dissolve it in water and prepare alkali, okay? It's prepared indirectly. So the indirect methods, they are not included in your course, okay? So let's not go into that. What is the indirect method? But remember that they are iron and copper, iron copper oxides, okay? They are insoluble in water. Okay, so after this table, the characteristics of oxides, the two oxides that we studied in detail, acidic oxide and basic oxide, these two are actually the summary of it, okay, whatever we discussed. So non-metals generally form acidic oxides that dissolve in water to form acidic solutions. Okay, so they dissolve to form acids. Acidic oxide, okay. So non-metals, okay, I'll write it. Why I'm writing with blue? Wait, it's dark. Yeah, okay. So non-metals, they form acidic oxides. Okay, when they react with oxygen, they form acidic oxides. And acidic oxides, upon reacting or upon dissolving in water, they give acids. Okay, similarly, the metals, most of the metals, upon reacting with oxygen, they give metal oxides or basic oxides. Okay, basic oxides. And when these basic oxides are dissolved in water, they give alkalis. Okay, alkaline solution. And these acids and alkalis, it's written that when these two things react with each other, then they neutralize the solution. They form salt and water, which we know, the neutralization reaction. Okay, so when acid and alkalis react, they give salt and water.
Ma'am?
Yeah?
What exactly is salt?
Salt? Salt are the combination of metals and the non-metals. Okay, so salt are like whatever salt you pick up, like if you take chloride, like sodium chloride, if you take sulfate, okay, like magnesium sulfate, if you take carbonate, like calcium carbonate, all of these are salts, okay, and they are the combination of metals and non-metals. So sodium is a metal, chlorine is a non-metal, okay, magnesium is a metal, sulfur and oxygen, they are non-metals, calcium is a metal, carbon and oxygen, they are non-metals. So salt is actually the ionic compound. Okay, first of all, it's ionic compound. Okay, and then it's a combination of metals and non-metals. Okay. The detailed study of salt is not included right now. You will study it in grade 9. Okay, in your exams, the topics which are coming from this chapter are 5.1, 5.2, 5.3 and 5.11. Okay, so these four are coming in your final exam from this chapter. And rest of the chapter, inshallah, you will study in grade 9. Okay, and salt is also included in it. So salt also you will study in detail in grade 9. Okay, but I gave you the intro of it. It's an ionic compound and it's made from metals and non-metals. Okay, it's neutral. Its pH is 7. Okay. Understood? Or any other thing?
No, ma'am. Understood.
No.
Okay. Okay. Now there are neutral amphoteric oxides. Okay. You have to tell me when the time finishes. Okay. Neutral amphoteric oxides. Neutral oxides are simple. Their pH is 7. Okay. They are neutral in nature, means they neither behave like acid nor bases, nor alkalis. Okay. So they are simple. They are not acids, nor they are bases or alkalis. So they are neutral. Their pH is 7. And we have three neutral oxides, which I discussed with you. Do you remember? What are those three? The three neutral oxides?
I do not remember.
Okay, you can see here on page 126, there is a flow chart, flow diagram. Okay, and in here in green box, neutral oxides are written. They're H2O, carbon monoxide,
CO and NO.
Yeah, and NO. These three are neutral oxides only. Okay, so please learn, please. Okay, learn them. These three are neutral oxides, H2O, CO, and NO. These three are neutral oxides, and rest of the non-metal oxides are acidic. Okay, neutral oxides are, they are actually non-metal oxides. Okay, but these non-metal oxides are neutral in nature. Rest of the non-metal oxides are acidic. Okay, similarly, the next topic of amphoteric oxide. In amphoteric oxide also, there are only two amphoteric oxides. Rest of the metal oxides are basic. Okay, and the two amphoteric oxides are written here in blue box. Zinc oxide and Al2O3, aluminium oxide. Okay, so please learn these two also, that only these two metal oxides are amphoteric in nature. Okay, rest of them are basic. Rest of the metal oxides are basic. And for the amphoteric oxides, in the key definition, it's written that amphoteric oxide or amphoteric hydroxide or metal hydroxide, a hydroxide or metal oxide that reacts with both an acid and an alkali to give salt and water. Okay, this is its definition, that an amphoteric oxide or amphoteric hydroxide, it reacts with acid and base or alkali both. Okay, so in both cases, it will give salt and water. Neutralization reaction means if it comes in contact with acid, it starts behaving like an alkali. And if it comes in contact with an alkali, it starts behaving like an acid. Okay, so it reacts as both. Last time also, when I gave you the introduction here. Okay, can you see the slide of the flowchart?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. In this one also, when I gave you the introduction, I told you about amphoteric oxides, then they react as base as well as acid. Okay, so these amphoteric oxides, they have the property of both. They react as base base or alkali, and they can act as acid also. Okay, so they change their colors depending upon the situation. Okay, and there are two amphoteric oxides, zinc oxide and aluminium oxide. Okay, so we will do the reactions of both of them, and these reactions are really important. Okay, amphoteric oxides are very important. This small chapter is coming. Okay, so the important thing, one of the most important thing is amphoteric oxides in it, and the reactions of amphoteric oxides. Okay, so we will do the reactions of amphoteric oxides. First, we'll discuss about zinc oxide, and then we'll discuss about aluminium oxide. Okay, so the first equation in your book, this is about zinc chloride and sodium hydroxide. This equation is actually the preparation of zinc hydroxide, how we will get zinc hydroxide. Okay, how we can prepare zinc hydroxide. So zinc hydroxide is again amphoteric hydroxide. So its preparation. Okay, number one amphoteric oxide is zinc oxide. Okay, or zinc hydroxide. both are amphoteric in nature. Okay, so first, in your book, the equation is about the preparation of zinc hydroxide. Okay, and after preparation of zinc hydroxide, first we will see its reaction with acid, that how it reacts with acid. Okay, and then we will see its reaction with alkali. Okay, because in the definition it's written that it has a unique property that because it's amphoteric, so it can react with acid and alkali both. Okay, so how it will react, we'll see. Okay, the preparation is the equation which is written in your book, that we will take zinc chloride plus NaOH. Okay, zinc chloride and sodium hydroxide. So we will take these two things. Okay, sodium will react with chlorine. Okay, because sodium has more tendency to react with chlorine. So sodium will react with chlorine forming NaCl. And this zinc will react with hydroxide. So we will get zinc hydroxide like this. Okay, in this way we can get zinc hydroxide and amphoteric hydroxide. Now we have to test the zinc hydroxide, that whether it is amphoteric oxide or not. Okay, whether it can react as both or not. So first we will do its reaction with acid to test it. Then we will do its reaction with alkali. So if it reacts with both of them, so it means that it's amphoteric in nature. Okay. So reaction with acid, we will take zinc hydroxide and any acid. Let's take HCl, okay, because it's simple. So we are reacting it with acid. Now when we react zinc hydroxide with acid, listen it carefully. When we react it with acid, then it behaves like an alkali. Okay, it becomes an alkali. And when acid and alkali react with each other, we know that they form salt and water. Salt plus water. Okay, so in this case, the salt which is formed is zinc chloride. Okay, so zinc chloride will form plus water. Yes. Okay, boys, have you understood this equation?
Then yes, ma'am.
Okay, when it reacts with acid, it becomes an alkali. Okay, so it behaves as an alkali. Now, reaction with alkali. So we will take zinc hydroxide, and we reacted with an alkali. Let's take sodium hydroxide. Okay, because it's the simplest one. Okay, so when it comes in contact with an alkali, it starts behaving like an acid. Okay, so zinc hydroxide will become acid. So again, acid and alkali will form salt and water. Okay, so the salt which it will form is sodium reacting with zinc and oxygen. Okay, zinc and oxygen which is present. So it will form sodium zincate, Na2 ZnO2. This salt is formed. It is known as sodium zincate. Okay, sodium zincate salt is formed plus water, H2O. Okay, so in both of the cases, zinc hydroxide is producing salt and water. So it means that it can act as both. When it reacts with acid, it reacts as an alkali. It becomes an alkali. Okay, and when it reacts with alkali, it becomes an acid. In both cases, it will give salt and water. So it means it's amphoteric. Okay, and these reactions are really important. And after this, we will do the reaction of aluminium hydroxide. So if you want to take the screenshot, you can take. Then we'll move forward. What has Zen written in chat box? From which metal and non-metal is pink salt made? pink salt. I think magnesium hydroxide. Sorry, magnesium sulfate. I'm not sure, but it's magnesium and sulfate, the pink salt. Okay, done. Should we move to the next slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next, we will do the reaction of aluminium hydroxide. The second amphoteric hydroxide is aluminium hydroxide. Okay. So we will test aluminium hydroxide also. There is no preparation method of aluminium hydroxide in your book. Okay, so we'll directly do its reactions. First, its reaction with acid. Okay. And then its reaction with alkali. Okay, let's complete it quickly. Okay, so aluminium hydroxide, ALOH, sorry, hold thrice. Whose mic is this? Aluminium hydroxide plus acid. We will take HCl here. Okay, so when it reacts with an acid, it behaves like alkali. Better turn off your mic. Yeah, good. Okay, so when it comes in contact with acid, it behaves like an alkali. Okay, so here it will form again salt and water. So salt which is formed is AlCl3, aluminium chloride. Okay, plus H2O, sorry, plus water. Okay, and reaction with alkali. When aluminium hydroxide reacts with an alkali, it becomes an acid. It changes its color. Okay, so it becomes an acid. So here, sodium will react with aluminium oxide. Okay, and it will form sodium aluminate, NaAlO2. Sodium aluminate salt. Okay, a salt plus water. So neutralization reaction. Okay, so in both cases, when there is acid reacting with it, when it's alkali reacting with it, it gives the reaction. So it's amphoteric. Okay, so it becomes an alkali when acid comes near it, and becomes an acid when alkali comes near it. And in both cases, it will give salt and water. Okay, so here in study tip, yes.
Period over.
Okay. Yeah, period is over. In study tip C, the reaction of reaction with alkali. Okay, reaction with alkali is written for sodium hydroxide and aluminium hydroxide also. Okay, reaction with acid is not written in your book, but it's important. Okay, so it can come how it reacts with acid. So you can take a screenshot and then you can go. Okay, we'll do the last topic 5.11 inshallah next week.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, beta. Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz, ma'am.
Yeah.
Allah Hafiz, ma'am.
Allah Hafiz.